As most seasoned boat anglers will be only too well aware, the weather isn't always as kind as it is here at Holyhead today. That usually leaves two alternatives, either abandon the trip or find somewhere sheltered to fish. Holyhead is one of those enviable locations where, in addition to having superb offshore boat fishing, the sheltered inshore stuff tucked in close to the breakwater and surrounding cliffs is of such a high quality as to give my way skipper Gethin Owen a valuable alternative option for days when boats based at less favoured venues would be confined to port due to strong winds. The harbour here is huge, with an area of around 700 acres protected by a breakwater of almost 2 miles in length, coming up out of very deep water. The outer wall, along with numerous coves and rocky points, is completely sheltered from the prevailing southwesterly wind. Little wonder then that it's such a popular venue throughout the spring, summer and back end months right up to Christmas, with some of its best big fish as well as sheltered bad weather marks little more than a few minutes sailing time from the harbour mouth. On this particular day, Gethin could quite literally have taken us anywhere, including the most distant marks out in Holyhead Deep for the big spur dogs. But that's another story. This day had been earmarked for a look at the inshore potential, and with that in mind, Gethin invited along Welsh international boat team member John Law and team manager Bob Roberts. Situations such as this make for vital practice sessions, which for them helps keep the match consistency factor high, and for me provided an interesting opportunity to compare international match tactics with those of pleasure angling. The bait for the day was a large communal tray of fresh ragworm, so no excuses there. Another common factor was the basic terminal tackle layout, which due to the snaggy nature of the ground and the fact that we were drift fishing, was mono droppers strung out above the lead. That said, the meticulous subtle differences in how the matchmen went about their business very quickly became apparent. Both used small strong hooks of around size 2, on droppers of maybe 12 inches in length, with either a bead or a small attractor on the snood butted up to the hook. The ragworm baits were nicked lightly through the head, leaving the majority of the body length hanging clear of the hook, and down at the bottom of the trace, the lead was attached using a paperclip as a weak link. Because bottom depth can be so up and down over heavy ground, John constantly checked the position of his lead in relation to the seabed to keep his baits in the feeding zone, while at the same time attempting to minimise the risk of getting hung up. After gently tapping the bottom with the lead, he would slowly put a few turns of line onto the spool before dropping back for a repeat of the same. This does two things. On the one hand, it lifts the lead out of the immediate snagging zone, but not so far as to take the baits too high above the fish, while on the other, that touch of movement with the bulk of the ragworm's length fluttering in the tide adds an element of potential escape to the baits, which can encourage fish to make a grab. Wrasse are pretty nonplussed about having their baits coming at them slightly above the heads, and pollock will even follow them up into mid-water and beyond when the mood takes them, so why risk hang-ups when taking evasive action might actually improve your chances of a take?
Through my window today, could have tripped out easy, but I've changed my way. It'll take time, I know it, but in a while you're gonna be mine, I know it. We're doing it in style, 'cause I made my mind. I'll tell you right now, ain't a trick in a book, and I'll be there, all that I can find. Superman or Green Lantern ain't got nothing on me. I can make like a turtle and dive far above in the sea.
Where areas of sand run close enough to the shore for it still to be sheltered, Geth can also put the anchor down. Time then to break out the heavier traces and bigger baits for a crack at the huss.
Okay, gents, doesn't seem too bad a tide down there.
Unfortunately, or should I say inevitably, expect dogs also to put in ashore.
That was heavy. It's your fish. It's your fish.
What have we got there? Suhas. Oh, that's lucky, isn't it?
Chuck the hook out. Yours, Mike?
I don't know, just clean it.
We've been fortunate today with the weather and that the sun's been shining, not much wind about. But even when we've got a strong southerly, southwesterly, even a southeasterly wind up to maybe 25-30 mile an hour, we can get out just into the bay here and have some good fishing with pollock, wrasse, cuckoo wrasse, ballan wrasse, corquins.
And if you happen to have a bucket full of pigler crabs handy, then a run over into nearby Church Bay, which also enjoys a fair degree of shelter, may be on the cards for the smoothhounds, the Welsh record for which, at £25 6 ounces, was caught aboard my way in 2007. But as with the spur dogs, again, that's going to be another story.